see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. You mad while I'm getting busy. Country girl running your city. Attitude bad on Sadidi. He only two times from the out like a lack, call him Ricky. And honestly, it ain't no cap in it. These bitches know ain't no cap in it. I like with a stack in it. I'm bout it, I'm bout it. Stop it, cause it ain't no acting it. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. Leaving my mark like a I see no biggie. Ain't biting my tongue. I can't be no goofy, no victim to none of my enemies. Like honestly, be sending me. Talk from a sit that a wee when I get to me. My check don't discriminate. Still take the positive if you talking Vietnamese. I just be having my way. Only care about what the page gonna say. Heard you wanna be, but don't gotta whip it. Rag on no petty. Look, stop talking that on your hip. If you ain't gonna rip it or pop it. Come to the like show me a benefit. Let me dumb it down. Benjamin, Benjamin. For you, we not equivalent. Really bad. Looking so innocent. Bossy predicament. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. You mad while I'm getting busy. Country girl running your city. Attitude bad on Sadidi. He only two times from the he out like a lack, call him Ricky. And honestly, it ain't no cap in it. These know ain't no cap in it. I like with a stack in it. I'm bout it, I'm bout it. Stop it, cause it ain't no acting it. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. Leaving my mark like a I see no biggie. Call me Hillary, stay at the bank. Making moves like I'm hot in the shank. I'm no key, but I pop out in blank. This bun on my knife, stop trying to look. They do not cover me. Fake, I can't keep no company. Only the real respect, my honest. So watch how you coming if you're under me. I'm with it in racks involved. All that text and calls. Just run me that. Making no sense at all. It bounce like a basketball. Your boo never coming back. This girl stupid, go dumb. Told that boy you gotta pay for some. I sit on no throne, you ain't taking none. You bragging on pass, I make for fun. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. You mad while I'm getting busy. Country girl running your city. Attitude bad on Sadidi. He only two times from the out like a lack, call him Ricky. Honestly, it ain't no cap in it. These bitches know ain't no cap in it. I like with a stack in it. I'm bout it, I'm bout it. Stop it, cause it ain't no acting it. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. Leaving my mark like a I see no biggie.
I ain't keeping up with what you was saying on the internet. I ain't keeping up with the news. But I get that daily paper. Stop playing me.
Tonight, from Mercedes-Benz Stadium in Atlanta, Georgia, it's the NFC Championship Game. Atlanta Falcons taking on the Seattle Seahawks.
The NFL playoffs are on EA Sports, and we've got a packed house here at Mercedes-Benz Stadium in downtown Atlanta. Coming up, it's a battle to represent the NFC in this year's Super Bowl, and we've got a classic in store between the Seattle Seahawks and the Atlanta Falcons. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. The postseason continuing here on EA Sports. And, man, it is electric in here, and it should be conference championship time.
I don't know about you, but my butterflies in my stomach, they have iron wings in this one. And every guy I've ever talked to has all said the same thing. This game, the conference championship game, may have more intensity than even the Super Bowl because you know what the stakes are. You're trying so hard to get to the big game. This is the one that's the real challenge.
So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. At a glance at the man under center at 6'5", he always demands attention.
I tell you what, when he is on schedule for that week, secondaries take notice because you've got to stay alert back there on every snap. A truly powerful arm, one that's capable of challenging any level of the defense on any given play. That's why so many scouts preach arm talent when preparing for the NFL draft. A quarterback with arm strength to make every throw in the book, he's an asset to have in any offense.
Yeah.
the gun on third down. Rich. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. This is good for a first down, his second grab of this NFC Championship bout. So opening drive, third down, they go with a slant, it works.
And I'm wondering when the league's going to figure it out, because everyone throws it on third down. You expect pressure, so you want the ball in the hands of the quarterback quickly. It's a three-step route ordinarily, and you're throwing it where you see the receiver breaking towards you. So it's an inside route. Everyone likes it, and it's executed very well.
Meanwhile, the throw here is complete, and they're going to get this up to midfield. Working with second and five now. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Same target, it's Jacobs again. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 33 yards that time.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Back to throw. Rich. That's caught left side to tight end Pitts. And the Falcons are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. Operating from the gun. Rich. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. A very costly sack there on third and goal pushes him back big time. And now you'd figure the field goal team coming on fourth. First down, a bit of a disaster, and now on second and goal, back even further. Operating from the gun, Rich, and caught by London. And they're going to be set up now with a ball at the 13-yard line. Interested to see what they dial up here, third and goal with a lot of green between them and the end zone. Touchdown! From 13 yards out. And the Falcons have struck first in this NFC title game. So they take the opening kickoff and drive it all the way down the field.
And that's the last thing you want defensively. On the road, in the playoffs, and now you're down a touchdown right away.
Point after here coming up. It's good, and that gives the Falcons a 7-0 lead. A good drive that time as they go 9 plays in all, and the Falcons score to cap it off. Atlanta's 11 ready to go, and they kick it away. From a yard or two deep, here comes a return. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. So out come the Seahawks now for their first possession. And trotting out there, no introduction needed for this guy around the league. Now in his 7th season as a QB.
And there's a word that constantly gets thrown around with this guy when you talk to anyone in the building. Potential. They are sky high on what they believe he can grow into in the role of a starting quarterback. In addition, there are plenty around the league who think that as well. And years from now, he can still be leading this offense out.
And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. They'll run. It's Kenneth Walker. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, 2nd and 2, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4. On 2nd down, it's Walker. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. A pair of 1st downs gives him a 1st and 10 up at the 44. Looking to throw. Kaufman got his man complete over the middle. It's Crawford. From the gun, it's Walker. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this 1st quarter. On 1st down, Kaufman on target to his man, likely. And they're going to get this down to about the 37. Here's 2nd and 5 now from the 37. Operating from the gun, Kaufman. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And they'll work this down inside the 30.
Didn't they tell us in our meetings that they needed to account for him on each and every play?
You think a guy of his caliber? So how does a guy like him get that wide open?
That usually means there's a tire breakdown on what the coverage was. Everyone thought they were doing something, and they were supposed to be doing something else. But bottom line is, no matter what, you have to know where he is and cover him on every play.
Here's a run on 1st down that won't even get back to the line of scrimmage. He will lose a yard, 2nd and 11.
Well, they sent the power set out there, and their job is to be man on man and move people so they can run the football. But that time, too many men didn't get moved in the box defensively. They end up throwing him for a loss.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's 2nd and 11. Back to throw. Kaufman. That's DK Metcalf running the slant. He's got it. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. And he remains perfect on this opening drive. Charles now 5 of 5 and another 1st down to work with.
He's like one of those great shooters in basketball that has his rhythm, has his confidence, and he doesn't think anything is going to miss right now. As far as he's concerned, he's going to be perfect the entire game, and who's to say that it won't happen the way he's throwing it right now.
Throwing on 1st down, Kaufman. That's complete right around the 8. Give him 9 there on the 1st down completion. From the 3, 2nd and 1 yard. Now to the ground, here's Walker. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. 1st and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. Operating from the gun, Kaufman. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. Another shot from the 1 on 2nd and goal. Walker will take this into the end zone for a Seahawk touchdown. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. 3 downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
Point after try forthcoming. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the 1st quarter, and we're tied 7-7. That one was an extended drive, 14 plays all told. And it was Ken Walker finishing things off with a touchdown run. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This will come out to the 25 as Lewis going to opt to not return it. So for the 2nd time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons offense. So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent author a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their time.
He's got a man complete. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
Well, big plays have been a hallmark of this offense all season, so there was no reason to think that it wouldn't continue here in this title game. Obviously, the magnitude of the event, not getting to them early.
So that changes things a bit. Here's a first and 10 all the way down at the 35. Looking to throw. Rich. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. On second down now, it's Stanley. And not much running room. Down to the 32. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Back to throw. Rich, he finds his man, complete. That's Harper. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks 16. His first catch in this NFC Championship game, and it's a first down.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver, although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice game.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He's got his pass catching tight end, that's Pitts. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. The middle, Stanley, and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown Atlanta, a 5-yard touchdown run, and the Falcons have moved out in front. So partner, it was a passing game that drove them down the field, but when they get close, they trust that man in the backfield, and he took them home.
And they trust their offensive line as well, because so many of these units, they specialize in either pass protection or run blocking. This group shows its versatility and gets both done on this drive.
Now the extra point. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter. So the drive there took six plays, and it's finished off with a 5-yard touchdown run. Atlanta's 11 ready to go, and they kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. Seattle's offense coming back onto the field, ready for their second drive.
And as the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want to carbon copy what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
You're right about that, partner. Sounds pretty simple, doesn't it? Just score again, but we know it's not that simple because we don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments to prevent a repeat of the last drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
And we'll find out here soon enough whether those adjustments are enough defensively. From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10. Walker now on first and 10. And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. It's a gain of 12, first down Seahawks. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
from Falcon territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Back to Walker on first down. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line. On first and 10, Kaufman complete to Likely. And they'll work this down inside the 30. Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. And they'll work from the 29 on second and 6. Up the middle, here's Walker. And he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4. Looking to throw. Kaufman finds his man over the middle. It's Likely. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down. They needed 4. He doubled that. He wound up getting 8.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What did the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him Old Reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push-off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Crawford. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll have a 2nd and 1 forthcoming. Left side here taken in by Metcalf. And the Seahawks are going to have a 1st and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. Here's Walker, and he's across the chalk, into the end zone, touchdown Seahawks. Kenneth Walker with his 2nd touchdown here in this first half. And the Seahawks are an extra point away from evening this one up. So his strong first half continues as he finds the end zone here for the 2nd time.
And definitely good blocking at the point of attack, and you just have to love watching the way he can create space down near the goal line. And he's able to take it into the end zone.
Now the try here for the point after. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive.
And it was Kenneth Walker finishing things off with a touchdown run.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Taken at the goal line. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Atlanta regains possession of the football. But right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on. Both sides moving the football, scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense on rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to seeing all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. Let's see if anyone slips up first. Can anyone counter with a nice little jab and get things going in their direction?
On first down, it's Stanley. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a first. Pretty explosive run on that inside handoff, and when you're a runner of his caliber, you don't need a big crease.
You really don't, but also what we're seeing is an offensive line that's taking charge at the point of attack, aren't we? Not only are they controlling the initial contact, they're actually utilizing what they call the strain the next 2 to 3 seconds to continue to move people.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Stanley. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. Now a give right side. Stanley. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of three. And guess what? It brings up third down. The Falcons on third down. A perfect 3-for-3 as they look to keep that streak going. Here it's third and three. So that'll be no better than an incompletion. And that'll bring up fourth down.
That goes in the category of a play that the defense is going to cherish and excites them. A completion, yes, you give up the pass, but no gain. I mean, that's exactly what you want on defense.
And sets up the fourth down. So out now comes the field goal unit for the Falcons. From the left hash, it's an even 50. And the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. Down the numbers. There he goes. Wow, first and goal, and defensively, all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. It would have been a long kick. It was prime fake field goal territory. They faked it. They got it.
So much for defense in this situation, because the natural play there is you go into what we call safe, meaning you don't really rush on that one. You almost concede. If they want to kick a long one like that and make it, so be it. You just don't give up the...
And this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. A great play there. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Falcons have broken our tie. CD, that's his second touchdown already. And how about this offense? Three drives, three touchdowns.
An absolute total team effort right now. And let's face it, I don't think he's done. We're still in the first half. There's a lot of time left to go. I don't know what they're going to do on the other side trying to slow him down. But right now, he's feeling it.
Now the extra point try forthcoming. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. So the drive winds up going 75 yards in seven plays. And the end result, an Atlanta touchdown. Atlanta's 11 ready to go, and they kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
Do it again, buddy. Do it again. Let's go.
Back out now comes Kenneth Walker and the Seattle offense. They're behind in the first half here, CD, but it's not through any fault of their running back. He's had a strong start to this one.
And you're right about that, partner, because watching him play, you would think that his team is in the lead. He has been a lot of fun in this contest. Now let's see if they can actually make something happen and put more points on the board behind his efforts.
Yeah, I'm curious to see, Charles, if they can play complementary football and get that passing game going as well.
Looking to throw on second down. Kaufman. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. And they're going to stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Here's second and 10. Operating from the gun. Kaufman throwing out left and finding Likely. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. Operating from the gun, Kaufman. And his throw is incomplete. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And he'll be brought down right on the 50. A gain of three. Here's play number seven on the drive. This is third and seven. Back to throw. Kaufman. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. It'll be a loss of eight on the sack. And it's going to lead him to fourth down.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both these offenses having their way so far. So maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game. Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and that will come the offense as they take over. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here.
Right now, everything they touch turns to gold. This is their fourth possession. Touchdowns on their first three possessions. I mean, this defense, they can't seem to stop them. It's like they're on skates.
Great analogy, Brandon, because they are pushing them back and winning everything at the line of scrimmage. They've just been laying down tracks towards the opposite end zone. So to themselves, all they're saying is, if we don't make a mistake, there's no way they can stop us.
Fifth catch of the game for him there.
Yeah, and the tight end position is now becoming a volume pass catcher. It used to be occasional, right, safety valve. Throw one to him every so often, but mainly they want him out there to block. Nowadays, an integral part of the passing game, and they create such great mismatches that they often become the leading receiver.
Now a quick slant as the throw is complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Off the play fake, Rich. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. A leap, and he's got it. He got it. It's a big play there for Atlanta. 42 yards.
Big plays are starting to become the trend here in this first half, and everything that they've tried has worked. And there's another example right there.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. It'll go down as a gain of 6. And it's second down. Again, he'll drop to throw. Touchdown, Falcons! From 8 yards out, and the Falcons go up by 2 touchdowns. Great corner route there, not only able to catch it, turn it upfield, and get into the end zone.
It usually involves a little bit of an extra move, doesn't it? You got to get them thinking that you're moving to the middle of the field, and you're breaking away to that corner. Boy, that was well executed.
No going for 2. They'll kick the point after. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. The drive summary that time, 5 plays. And the Falcons score to cap it off. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fields it right around the goal line. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. A last series form, a little disappointing, forced to punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, first and 10. Throwing to start the drive, Kaufman. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. And he will be brought down at about the 43 that time. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
They are in need of 6 yards here if they hope to move the chains.
On third down, Kaufman. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down.
Like what I see so far out of this defense, because they've been showing their best coverages on third down. So far, only allowed one conversion on a handful of attempts. One area of their game plan that they've executed to perfection.
The Seahawks send out their punter as he'll punt it away for the second time. They call that a punt of 38 yards officially.
And it will be Falcon football. Their quarterback in this offense heading back out to the field. He had the touchdown pass on the last drive, his third already in this first half, as he'll try again with a first down.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. Oh, he's got some breathing room. There he goes, right side. Touchdown, Falcons. A big play there. On his way to a monster game, three first half touchdowns.
And the Falcons continue to show why it pays to play at home in the postseason as they add on to their lead.
On this stage, conference championship game, every play is magnified, and that was a big play.
No doubt about it. One thing that has these guys a step away from a shot at a big game, their big play ability. They can strike from anywhere.
Extra point attempt here still to come. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Those are the ones the offensive coordinators dream about. One play drives from that distance. What an effort. It results in the touchdown.
And he won't quite make it to the 25.
Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. They trail early on the road in the playoffs. Not a great combination as they've got it first and 10. Throwing to start the drive, Kaufman. This went into the hands of Metcalf. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. He finds his man complete. It's Chambers. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. They're going to need to get up and set in a hurry. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work this to the 45.
And now they're in the hurry up. On first down, Kaufman. That is caught by Fountain. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
And I don't think there's any question that this offense is going to need to hit on a few more plays like this. It's been a difficult first half for them, to say the least. And I do believe if they want to get back in this game, they need to start right now. It's kind of like making adjustments. If you try and wait until the half, it's probably too late. They need to get going right here.
He's got Wilson, middle of the field. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 55 seconds to go until halftime. This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. This will be caught just inside the 10. Now another timeout called for by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. To throw on second down, Kaufman. it's complete. And this play doesn't go anywhere. Backwards, losing yardage to the 11. Big play coming here. It's third and goal. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. This will be caught just inside the 10. They wind up with six on the hook up there, but it's not enough. Fourth and goal. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get three to end the first half. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And his kick is good. And the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. So a late three there, and that'll help as they head into the break.
Talk about situational football and something they've worked on since the OTAs and minicamps the previous summer. They take care of the ball, get 3 points, knowing they're going to get the ball to start the second half. That's the old two-for-one special to finish things off.
So we've reached halftime here in the NFC Championship as we'll head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks. As always, one half remains in the Battle of the Sea. He will take home that George Halas Trophy and represent the NFC in the Super Bowl. We'll get back to you guys in just a moment. But first, let's look back to the AFC Championship game held earlier today. And it's the Kansas City Chiefs who are heading to the Super Bowl as they await the winner of this NFC Championship game. So with that, let's get you right back out for the second half as one of these teams will represent the NFC in the Super Bowl. To find out who, let's turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
Coach, thank you very much as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Halas Trophy still hangs in the balance as the second half now underway in the NFC Championship game. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Seahawks offense set to go to begin this third quarter. And they have work to do in the second half if they want to earn that berth to the Super Bowl.
And I'm pretty sure this is where their coaches at halftime were saying don't panic and then demonstrating it by not making a lot of drastic changes to the game plan. Let's just get back to doing what we've been doing all year long. That should be more than good enough.
And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Looking to throw on second down. Kaufman. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Looking to throw. Kaufman. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Just a yard of the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 3. Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They'll try for the first with Walker. And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. First down Seattle on a pickup of 13.
The more football I watch, the more I want to check and see if teams are going to panic when they're down on the scoreboard. And this team has shown no signs of doing that. A lot of the time, they come out after the half. Things haven't worked so well in the first go-around. They want to throw the football like crazy. But the way to open up throwing the ball is to run it, and they've run it well here to start the second half.
Throwing on first down. Kaufman, he finds his man, complete. It's Chambers. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. To throw on second down. Kaufman. And the ball is knocked out. And the Falcons grab it. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Well, if these guys wanted to get back in this game, they needed an almost perfect second half. And down three scores, a lost fumble here certainly doesn't fit into that plan.
That reminds me of my plan in college to get an A on the papers I turned in, but that didn't work out too well either. Too many mistakes by both of us. I mean, that's just pure and simple. And that's why that's exactly where they are in this ball game. They're going to need a huge turnaround if they want to try and win this one.
And they'll run the option to start the drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
It looked like almost a miscommunication defensively, because once he decided to keep it, he had pretty smooth sailing.
Yeah, it became a question of, wait a minute, who's got the quarterback? And when you talk about miscommunication, it's supposed to be called assignment football on the defensive side of the ball, but the assignment gets mixed up. That's the end result.
He's going to keep this again. Same exact result as last play, a pickup of 11.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it. But it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
They'll run on first down. It's Stanley, and he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. They'll try and run the option left side. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And a 5-yard gain as he's down inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. From the 28, it's second and 5. Operating from the gun, Rich. That's into a crowd and intercepted. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will take this one home.
Boy, a big play right there. I mean, a touchdown on this drive could have really put some separation on the scoreboard. Instead, it's the defense who scores. And, partner, we got a game again.
And we do have one because of what you just described, a defense that understood what was going on in this game and did something about it. They knew their offense needed some help. They just provided it. They're back in this one.
Extra point attempt to come here. And that one makes this an 11-point deficit now. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away.
Taking it about the 1.
And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here.
Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
And sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it.
The ball comes out, and the Seahawks have picked it up.
Well, you had an offense working with a comfortable two-score lead here in the third quarter, and certainly doesn't feel as comfortable now following the turnover.
Yeah, you're right about that, because now the nerves start to come into play a little bit. You're a little bit jangled. You don't want to give your opponents any avenues to get back into the game. What you'd rather do, put up signs and say, "Roads closed."
Good starting field position here for the Seahawks as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up.
Well, he tried to bounce it outside, but that's obviously not his game. He's too much of a straight line runner.
Yeah, him in the outer third of the field, not a recipe for success. That time a loss. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Operating from the gun, Kaufman over the middle, complete. It's Crawford. And he is going to have a Seahawks 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
3rd and 4 is always a tough call. Maybe a little too long to run for it, but not too long to hit him on the quick slant. And that was well executed. Found the window and zipped it right in there.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. They'll toss this out right to Walker. And they got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more. Operating from the gun, Kaufman. And a quick throw here, that's complete. No gain on the play. And that's going to make it 4th down. So they go pass on 3rd and 2. They complete it, but no gain. Should they have tried to run it?
I thought that running the ball in that situation is what they would have done, because at worst case scenario, you may bring up a 4th down decision for your team. Instead, now they're not close to the 1st down.
Needing the tough yards, they run it with their fullback. And boy, is he close. Did he get there? No, they're going to say he's short of the line to gain. But look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. He's already hit pay dirt twice. He's up over 100 yards. He is feeling good.
And he's just zipping along today. Everything coming together for him. It's that type of a day that you see a back just kind of have a grin on his face every time his number is called, because he doesn't feel like there are going to be any lost yardage plays. Nothing but big-time positive runs.
Faking the sideline grin as well. He finds his man complete. That's Stanley. It'll be a nickel look here for the Seahawks on 3rd down. Operating from the gun, Rich. He finds his man complete. It's Stanley. And he is going to have a Falcons 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Brandon, a lot of times you'll see running backs rotate in and out of the game, whether it's completed pass, a good run, it doesn't matter. Here, not only does he stay in, but they go right back to him, and he makes another nice play, back-to-back catches.
On 1st and 10, Rich into the hands of London. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Up the middle they go. Stanley. And some nifty running here as he'll take this across midfield and down to the 47. 140 yards rushing for him now as he tries to will his guys into the Super Bowl.
Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same, whether it's handed off inside or the quarterback keeps it, that allows you to fool the defense so often. And in this case, fooled them with the inside run.
And he'll get this down only to about the 46.
Looking to throw on second down. Rich. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. And the Seahawks are going to take over at their own 11-yard line. Boy, that one was in the air for an agonizingly long time.
Just begging to be picked off, wasn't it? It's one thing if you're throwing a ball like that, trying to throw someone open or lead them into an area. But that ball needed to be thrown with a lot more conviction. As a result, it's an easy interception.
And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. A kind of a lucky break on the prior drive, Charles. The turnover on downs that the offense had didn't come back to bite them after the other side, their defense came through, was able to hold them without any points.
I would agree with you, partner. A little bit of a lucky break indeed, but you know what they'd say to us? No luck, just pure skill. We rose to the challenge, and we didn't permit a score. That's how we roll.
Well, I'm kind of curious, Charles, if they might temper their aggressiveness now offensively if they get in that fourth down spot again.
Yeah, one would think so, but maybe because they held them, they might go for it again.
To throw on third down, Kaufman. He finds his man. Oh, he put it on the carpet, a fumble, and the Falcons grab it. And they're going to mark, and this is going to be brought back. It's a scoop and score for the Falcon TD. So a great play there by the defense. If these guys are going to advance, and it looks like they will, this defense a big reason why.
And they love carrying the mantle for this team, don't they? You see the way that they move around out there? They want to lead this team deeper into the playoffs and hopefully onto the Super Bowl.
And that return for a touchdown certainly helps that.
And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble.
On first down, Kaufman.
And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
We're in the third quarter of the NFC title game. This is second and 10. Throwing again. Kaufman got his man complete over the middle. That's Chambers. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Back to throw. Kaufman firing quickly here, and that's complete. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. That'll go for a gain of seven. And that's going to make it fourth down. The Seahawks send out their punter as he's on here to punt it away. So possession goes over here on the punt.
And it will be first and 10 as they take over.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line.
As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that.